Clint, obviously extremely early in the process, but how do you see the assimilation going and the learning process and the teaching?
It's been good. You know, two practices in, guys have a lot to learn, you know, mainly just how to practice and how to stay up. But we've been really pleased with it thus far.
What are you seeing, I guess, from yourself being in this role and position with a new organization?
Yeah, it's been really fun. It's been really rewarding to work with really good people, starting with Coach Allen. And, you know, we got some really good coaches on our offensive staff. So we're gelling together as a staff as well as getting our players better.
Clint, when you're working with a lot of veteran players on understanding a new playbook, new system, guys who've maybe been in a system for a long time, what's kind of like your thing where you're trying to, like what's your big thing that you want these guys to take away from the early part of this?
This time of year, it's all teaching, you know, installation and trying to slow it down, you know, starting from scratch and not assuming anything, just trying to be really good at the details and just understanding, like you said, there's first-year guys, rookies, and we got 13-year veterans. So we're going to keep it simple initially and just make sure we're as detailed.
Clint, do you envision utilizing Alvin Kamara very similar to McCaffrey?
Yeah, I think it'll be really fun to work with Alvin. You know, he's got a great skill set that we can do a lot of things with. So I think it's just up to us as coaches identifying those things and him putting in the work.
One of the things with the Sean Payton offense that we've seen for a long time here is like kind of famous for those really long play calls. Like, how would you describe the verbiage of your offense? What do you try to do?
Yeah. Well, I can't speak for that for Coach. You know, I would say that we're a West Coast offense for whatever that means to everybody. You know, we're going to be probably as wordy as the quarterback can handle, and I think our quarterback is a very smart player. He can handle a lot. I think, you know, we're going to challenge him early this time of year in the off season, and him and his teammates, and see what they can handle.
Why did you feel like New Orleans was the right place for the next step in your career?
I think it just came down to the people that you're working with. Coach Allen gave me an opportunity, and Mickey Loomis. You know, getting to work with guys that I've worked with before and been in the fire with, like Rick Dennison and Andrew Janoco, and some new coaches that I'm learning that I'm really impressed with. So it all comes down to the people. It's a hard job with long hours, so you got to be around people that you respect and have your back, and we have that here.
Yeah, Clint, how much does it help that you do have a veteran quarterback that you can, you know, that can handle the verbiage? Because obviously you want to accelerate the process as much as you can.
Oh, it helps tremendously. And Derek has. He's had a really good offseason thus far. He's putting in the work. He's here after hours. Just really studies his tail off, and then his teammates see how hard he works, and he brings their level of play up as well.
If there were a couple things that you would say define your kind of like philosophy, like what would a couple of those things be?
You know, we're just stressing the players this time of year to be smart, tough, and dependable. And regardless of the scheme and what that brings, you know, if we can just start with that, we'll be in good shape come training camp as we keep working.
And just,
what was it about?
Well, I think, you know, our scouting department did a great job of, identifying all the players that we've drafted. But we like a lot of things about Spencer, but the things that take no talent, you know, and to me that is his attention to detail really stuck out. You know, his effort, his drive to be better, you know, to me that doesn't take a whole lot of talent. It's something that's inside, and he has that in spades. Yeah, it's 2 days into it. It's two practices into it. He has been excellent, as well as Kellen Mond in the meeting room. So it's been a positive start.
How about Taliosefuaga? He seemed like, of all the offensive tackles you guys were scouting around, one had done the most wide zone run blocking. I mean, does he feel like a good fit for this offense in particular?
Yeah, we definitely think so. And we love the person. We love his work ethic. And we love the type of teammate that he was at Oregon State. So amongst all the skills that made him a first-round draft pick, it's really the intangibles that he brings that we're really looking forward to.
And I know Coach said you guys are going to look at him at left tackle because you've seen him at right tackle. What about him makes you think he could possibly be good at either position?
Oh, he's a tremendous athlete. You know, we identified that early, just how athletic he is, how mean he is, you know, in a good way. And we definitely wanted to see what it looks like at left for this camp.
How do you think so far he's handled the mental load of doing that, switching positions, in addition to everything else the rookies are kind of learning now?
Yeah, well, one of the huge reasons we drafted him was his intelligence, you know, and he's been, just like all the other guys, putting in a lot of work. He came out and definitely has not disappointed, but again, it's 2 days into it, and we're not going to crown anybody or go the other way on the first 2 days, but we are happy with what we got thus far.
How is Bo look to you in the first 2 days?
Yeah, Bubba's in the same way. You know, he brings a lot of positive energy. He got a big smile on his face. He really likes football, which is important because we're here long hours, and you got to love it in order to be a great player. So he's had a good first step.
When you look at Derek's season last year, it's obviously some highs and lows. You get that with every quarterback. But like, what was kind of the main takeaway for you when you were kind of going back and looking through all that? And you know, how do you pull more of the highs out, I guess?
Yeah, well, I mean, I've followed his career since he's been drafted out of Fresno State. So I've seen, you know, I've been in his division and see him come back and beat us many times. So he's got a lot of talent. He's been with some really intelligent coaches. He has a lot of football up in his mind right now. And we're just trying to slowly install our system and take it one day at a time. And, you know, the main thing I'd say about that is I think he just has a grit about him. And I really love his grit and his smarts. And that's something that we're just going to keep building on with him.
Is there anything about what you've seen with him in the past that makes him a really good match for this system from the get-go?
Athleticism. You know, he's a really good athlete. You know, I think that's something that's not said enough about him. So, that's the main thing that I saw.
Taysom Hill has obviously had like a really unique role in this in the offense. They've ran here for a long time. I don't know if that fits what you do in your scheme, but like you have to kind of look at what he did and try to figure out how it works in that.
Yes, you know, Taysom has been phenomenal here early. We've been kind of moving him in a lot of spots, as he's done his entire career, really intelligent guy. So looking forward to just kind of, you know, giving him a lot of volume early, and then we'll start narrowing it down as we get closer to the season.
What are some of the things just from last year being in San Francisco that you feel like were maybe influential on you, or were maybe like a learning experience or eye-opening or anything like that?
Yeah, I would say just the entire organization, you know, starting with Kyle, the way that he runs the team and he runs the offense. And it was just a real pleasure to be around him last year and see his work ethic and see how he treats his players and that, you know, the way that he game plans.
But you guys have like a lot of young coaches on the staff, but also like some experience, especially on the offensive line side with Rick and John. How important was it for you to get two guys with a couple decades of experience and especially at that position?
Yeah, that was critical. It always is. I think, you know, Coach Dennison and Coach Benton are a huge piece of us having success, and really lucky, really fortunate to get to work with them again.
What do you want the identity of your offense to be?
Yeah, that's up to the players, you know. We gotta see what we're going to be good at, and that's to be determined. And they're off to a good start, though.
Any particular of your previous positions that you'd say were most influential in the type of offensive coordinator you believe you are now?
Yeah, it's not one thing, you know. It's not. And I think I've been really lucky to be around a lot of different guys, whether it was the air raid in college, or you know, being in the West Coast, or being with North Turner and the digit system. And there's a lot of ways to do things, and I think that we're starting to work on what our identity is going to be. We're putting our offense in, we're taking it slow, and who we're going to be, like I just said, is going to be up to our guys more than it is about me.
When you came in the offseason, I took a look at kind of what happened to the offense last year. I think the Saints had the second worst yards per carry. When you like looked at it, could you identify kind of maybe why that was, or what your takeaway was, and was there an easy fix to that? It's probably never an easy fix.
Yeah. No, you know, we're just looking at the players and the roster and the guys we have, and we're moving forward, and we're trying to build on what we can be this year.
Obviously, offensive philosophies adapt and evolve all the time, but you get paired with your dad all the time and his philosophy and Mike Shanahan's philosophy. Is there some things about those core principles that still ring and, you know, don't need to change?
Yeah, absolutely. That is our foundation. You know, those two guys, that's our bedrock. That's where we're starting. That's what Coach Dennison and Coach Benton are bringing. And, you know, what we do from there kind of, you know, we'll just evolve as we install our offense. But we want to have that same type of a foundation that Mike Shanahan started.
And is it fair to say, as simple as it sounds, the run game and the play-action passing game are still two great foundations to have in an offense? Or?
Absolutely, yeah. And you can't play action if you can't run it. So we definitely got to be really cognizant about being good teachers and installing our run game.
How will you use your father as a resource going forward? I mean, you have a lot of your own experience now and probably your own ideas too. But how do you expect to use him, like a daily sounding board or just once in a while when something hits you and you're like, I wonder what he thinks?
Yeah, every day, you know, I would talk to him most days, and you know, he's definitely going to be dialed in to what we're doing. And But I also have, you know, him, and I have Coach Dennison that's coached with them for so long, and that's really almost the same brain right there. So really lucky to get to work with Rick.